Hello everyone, welcome to K-Port. My name is Michelle and I'm so glad you're here watching Konnect HQ with me today. We are doing a lesson from a series called God is My Dad, and it's called Look Like Your Dad. So some people know their dad, but some don't. But we all can know the best dad, God, our Heavenly Father. God, our Father, is the one who is one, Daddy to us all, creating us in His image and meeting our needs through the wonder of His creations. Two, loving, never turning His back on us, but waiting patiently for us to reach out to Him and experience His blessing, forgiveness, and validation as worthy sons and daughters of God. Three, honest and faithful, even when we are not, holding to every promise He has written in our heart and in His word. Four, He is transformative, giving us salvation in Christ, the Holy Bible, the Holy Spirit, and communion with Him as tools to save us from sin nature into reflections of His glory. So I have a question for you. What would it be like if it were Christmas every single day? You know what? I'm gonna have my friend Miss Stephanie answer it this time. Go ahead.
Hey guys. Well, if Christmas was every day, does that mean I would get presents every day?
I think so.
That would be amazing.
Yeah.
I mean, to get a present every single day, who wouldn't want that?
You are so right. Thank you so much, Miss Stephanie. I hope you come back.
You're welcome.
So today's point is, God gave the first Christmas gift to show us how to love and live. Say it with me. God gave the first Christmas gift to show us how to love and live. Way to go! Now, you are not going to believe how the Konnect HQ crew is celebrating Christmas this year. I mean, it's better than a bag of snakes, some funnel cakes, a disco ball, but that's not all. Trust me, you're going to have to watch it.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and sing, and heaven and nature sing. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of His righteousness, and wonders of His love, and wonders of His love, and wonders, 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 wonders of
love.
newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all the nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ by highest heaven adored, Christ the everlasting Lord. Late in time, behold Him come, offspring of the Virgin's womb. Veiled in flesh, the Godhead see, hail the incarnate deity. Pleased is man with men to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the new. Hail the heaven-born Prince of Peace, hail the Son of Righteousness. Light and life to all He brings, risen with healing in His wings. Mild He lays His glory by, born that man no more may die.
God wants us to look like Him by living a life showing God's love to everybody. Jesus gives us an example of how to live a life like that. If you've never decided to follow Jesus, you can make that choice today. All you have to remember are the ABCs. A, admit. Admit that you've done wrong and ask God to forgive you for disobeying Him. B, believe. Believe God sent Jesus to take the punishment for your sin. Trust that you're forgiven because Jesus made you right with God. C, choose. Choose to spend your whole life depending on God's power to help you say no to sin. As you live and love like Jesus, tell others God is your leader and number one friend. If you want to make that decision today, be sure to talk about it with your Konnect small group leader before you leave. We hope you have a very Merry Christmas. And before we go, we have one more song that tells us what Christmas is all about. Let's go!
To Nazareth and meet a girl named Mary. An angel came and said she'd have a baby. Not only that, but it'd be God's son she'd carry. And though this happened a long time ago,
let's go
and see what Joseph slept and dreamed the night away. He wondered what to do about this baby. With Mary as his wife, what would people say? An angel told him, don't be afraid.
Let's go. Go tell it on the mountain. Jesus Christ is born.
Now as
they traveled all the way to Bethlehem. Counted there because the ruler's high command. Poor Mary was so tired there was no room in the inn. A stable would be part of God's great plan.
Let's go.
Out to hills where shepherds watched the flock by night. When angels came and told them of an amazing sight. To you a child is born in Bethlehem this very night. Peace on earth, glory to God on high.
Let's go. Go tell it on the mountain. Tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Let's go.
East where wise men watched the night sky. Found a new star shining and wondered why. Wondered if a king is born, if it was a sign. The star will guide us with his holy light.
Let's go.
Find the wondrous gift God gave us long ago. His one and only son who came to us so we could know. Forever God is with us, now it's up to us to show. The love of Jesus so the world can know.
Let's go. Go tell it on the mountain. Tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Let's go.
Ebenezer Scrooge needed an entire night and three ghosts to show him how to love people. I could have done it in an hour.
Dot, Dot, wake up.
I'm awake.
Is this real haze or dream haze?
Konnect HQ needs you, Dot. You must find three people who have low spirits and find a way to cheer them up.
I can do it. You give me the Scrooges and I'll give you results. I just need one other thing.
Name it.
Music!
We are Konnect HQ.
Every day
we help the people of the world
live God's way.
We look for the links,
make the connection,
and you never know what might happen.
My name is Dot, and this is my musical Christmas dream. Why so glum, chum?
Tomorrow's Christmas.
Shouldn't that make you excited?
It does, but then after Christmas is a day that isn't Christmas, and then another day that isn't Christmas. There's a whole year full of days that aren't Christmas. It bums me out.
Christmas is a great day to celebrate the birth of Jesus, but it doesn't have to stop there. That was just the beginning. Check this out.
This is his 66 picks mixed up into one. The books about God, who he is and what he's done. It's the Holy Bible, y'all, with God's truth packed out inside. It's alive, of Christ to hide in your heart and in your mind. Old Testament's a setup for the big event. When Jesus crashed the scene with a new arrangement. It's history, his story, whose story, God's story. Oh, the story of how much he loves me. Let it blow up all the pages, let this show go mad. Let his word explode from this video into your life.
This is the story of Jesus. If you've ever heard it before, then you might think the story of Jesus begins long ago on a star-filled night in a little village of Bethlehem.
When Mary, his mother, gave birth to him in a stable.
And that is a part of the story.
But that wasn't really the beginning at all.
You see, that was no ordinary night.
And Jesus was no ordinary baby.
To find the true beginning of the story of Jesus, we have to go back.
All the way back. To the beginning of history.
To the very beginning of everything.
When we do, we find out that Jesus was there and that he was very busy.
Because long before he came into the world as a little baby, he was with God the Father in the very beginning.
And he was about to accomplish some of his very best work,
creating absolutely everything.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In the beginning was the Word. Jesus was the Word.
Everything that was created received its life from Jesus, the Word.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and the earth was formless and empty.
Darkness was over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God hovered over the waters.
Then God spoke and said, "Let there be light." And those words brought life, and that life was the light of all mankind.
The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness will never stop it.
Jesus, who was the one true light, who gives light to everyone, came into the world.
The Word, that's Jesus, became human and made his home among us. He came into the very world he created.
He came so we would see God.
He grew into a boy, who grew into a man, who died on a cross for our sins.
He showed us what love looks like.
He showed us what God looks like.
And when we love him back, we become children of God.
So we can live like him and love like him.
And we can show the whole world what God looks like too.
And that is the story of Jesus.
Jesus was born to show the world how to live a life of love. And we can do that every day, even if it isn't a holiday.
How?
I'm so glad you asked.
What's that music? And where is it coming from?
This is a musical.
How did it know to start playing?
Stop asking questions, go with it.
When I wake up, the day is a gift that I can't wait to start. A new melody is waiting for me. I can hear it in my heart. If you wanted the sun but got showered, oh, if you needed the sweet but got soured, don't you ever forget you're empowered with song. Be swinging as soon as you're singing with me. The song in your head, the tap in your toes, that dance you think is strange, it's just what we need, so you take the lead, and the whole wide world could change.
What if I don't know the words?
I can teach you.
What if I sing off key?
I'll out screech you. Don't think about it, just reach deep and let it out. Sing with me, we're better together. Sing with me, don't make me do this by myself. Feel free to add to the vocals. Believe me, I need your help. I would be so upset without our sweet. So start vocalizing with me.
Singing is an easy way we can show the world that God changes our spirits when we choose to follow Jesus. Look for the musical moments in every day.
Okay, let's sing another one.
I really wish I could, but I've got other people to cheer up. Why so sad, lad?
'Cause I know I'm not gonna get what I want for Christmas.
What did you ask for?
Same thing I ask for every year. A frog army.
Tell me more!
Well, it's exactly how it sounds. It's an entire army of frogs that'll do whatever I say. I mean, what do you get the guy who has everything?
Frog army.
Exactly, but I never get it.
But Christmas isn't a time to dream up better gifts than the best gift we already got. What do you get for the world who needs everything?
Jesus.
Exactly. God gave the first Christmas gift to show us how to love and live.
Jesus was sent to earth to give everyone an example of how to look and act like God, our heavenly dad. God sent the first Christmas gift to show us how to love and live.
It's not bad to have a Christmas list. Just don't forget the most important part of this season.
Thanks, Dot. So, what did you put on your list?
I'm so glad you asked. I've edited my list to be a model of simplicity. Take a look, I think you'll see my list is just as short as me. All I really want is a bag of snakes, some funnel cakes, a disco ball, but that's not all. Feed a dolphin, drive a blimp, ride a seesaw with a chimp, a bookcase, secret passageway, a unicorn on roller skates, surfing lessons, bumper cars, and some ninjas throwing stars. A tire swing, some jelly beans, a cool tattoo, but I'm not through. Find a banjo, learn the banjo, teach a chimp to play the banjo. A boat that is unsinkable, a sock that is unstinkable, a flying squirrel, a time machine, and HQ needs a submarine. If you find it hard to get all my wishes, don't you sweat, I'll settle for a drum set.
Well, that's detailed.
Oh, what is this?
Sounds like another person needs my help. Why so cross, boss?
Do you mind explaining this?
It's a gingerbread house.
But what's it for? What's its purpose?
It's a gingerbread house.
Yes, I can see that. But do you have a permit to build it?
Nope.
That's a violation code 53-17. Do you have an icing permit?
I took the test, but didn't pass.
That's a violation code 2020-3.
You seem more upset than usual. Come on. What's going on?
Day after day, I find a mess, I issue a safety warning, and I've had it to about here. It's a lot of paperwork.
I get it. Do you maybe want to sing about it?
So glad you asked.
Let it all out, big guy.
Oh, 7-80-3015. I'm being bummed daily by the troubles I've seen. Another day, another mess, it's taking its toll. I might be keeping you in line, but I'm losing control. I need some cooperation or a pleasant vacation from handing out these citations. Got the safety code blues. Is it too much to ask to get a little relief? 'Cause I'm pulling out my hair and I'm losing sleep. Is it too much to ask to get a little respect? I've got a small amount of patience, but there ain't much left. Cabinets, no running in the halls, no dancing on the ceiling, no songs that don't rhyme. Another day, another chance to show some compassion. I've been wearing out my catchphrase in an orderly fashion. By my estimation, all my irritations come from these violations. Got the safety code blue.
That's some heavy stuff.
It's like everywhere I look, I see mistakes.
What if I told you I've got a cure for your blues?
I'd say tell me all about it.
We can talk about someone who never made mistakes. Let's memorize this verse from the book of Ephesians, chapter 5, verse 2. It goes like this. Ephesians 5:2. Live a life filled with love.
Live a life filled with love.
Following the example of Christ.
Following the example of Christ.
Jesus Christ came to earth and lived a life without mistakes so we could see a clear example of how we should live.
So next time I'm feeling the blues, I should just open up my Bible and spend some time with God.
It could help.
Thanks, Dot. Hey, you mind if I keep the sunglasses? They make me feel kind of cool.
Consider it my Christmas gift to you. That. I helped 3 people and it hasn't even been an hour. Take that, Charles Dickens! Now what? I guess I should wake myself up. But a musical can't end without a big full cast finale. Hit it!
Angels, we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains. Angels, we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains.
Live a life filled with love. 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 Live a life filled with love.
When the world has got me down and feeling trampled, you remind me that it's time to get up. I can slide into the room, be an example.
I'm Dot, and this is our Christmas message. The Bible tells us this in the book of Ephesians. Ephesians 5:2. Live a life filled with love, following the example of Christ. Jesus showed us how to live a life of love. If we want to look like God, we should follow the example of Jesus and share his love. Jesus is God's Son, and he's been there since the very beginning. Throughout time, Jesus has shown us how to live and love like God. Jesus died for us to make us right with God. Jesus is God's first Christmas gift to us. We can sing loud about the love that God shows us and show the world what Christmas is all about. Learning to live and love like God our Father will show others what God looks like, and they'll want to follow Jesus too. God gave the first Christmas gift to show us how to love and live. Merry Christmas, and remember, Konnect HQ is here to wake up, Dot. Wake up, Dot. Wake up!
Dot, it's time to decorate Christmas cookies.
Whoa, what day is it? Did I sleep through Christmas?
Nope, It's still Christmas Eve.
You were talking in your sleep. Sounded like you were making a transmission.
I was. I learned a lesson, and there was singing, and there was dancing, and it was wonderful.
Well, it may not be a musical, but we could sing Christmas songs while we decorate our cookies.
I would love that.
Angels we have heard on high,
sweetly singing o'er
the. Accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior is the most important decision that you can make. If you want to learn more about that, talk to a trusted adult as soon as this video ends. Wow, Christmas is amazing. Jesus is such a great gift to show us how to love and live like God, our heavenly dad. The Bible verse is such a great way to celebrate that. Say it with me. Ephesians 5:2, live a life filled with love, following the example of Christ. You got it. I'm so glad you joined us in Kport today for Konnect HQ. We have some great discussion questions and an activity to do with your family. Just click the lesson activity link below this video on the Kport online page to access the activities to do with your family. Well, that's it from me. I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.